I'm going to show you how to make the main part of the HydroSock passive wick hydroponic system. You need a 1 gallon milk or water jug. Don't cut the top off yet. Spray paint it with a highly reflective silver or chrome paint, and then you can cut off the top. And this is about the size and shape that it needs to be cut. I also masked off the jug right there on the handle to leave a little window to see the nutrient levels on the jug. Now, the reason why I spray painted this jug is because over the last 3 months I've been using an experimental one just like this, and it has cut down the algae growth significantly, about maybe half. And I've been using it in my greenhouse for about 3 months, and I decided this is the way to go. Yeah, the things that you need, the basic items that you need to make the HydroSock are what's shown on the table. You need just a plastic drinking cup. Well, I actually need two of them. These are the 8 ounce. Any color is fine. Any brand doesn't really matter. Because you're going to cut those down and put them together, and I'm going to show you in just a minute. You need just a plain men's cotton sock. Size 10 to 13 is pretty good. Wash it first before you use it, if you're using a used one or a new one for that matter. You need some bamboo skewers. This is actually one skewer cut in half. That's going to help set this on the ledge of the container when you're done. You need a couple tie wraps. Actually, you'll need 3 tie wraps, and I'll show you why in just a little bit. And a hole punch. You're going to cut your 2 cups down to about a third height, and then they're going to be nestled. You're going to take one and put it inside the other. Now, the reason for this is primarily for strength. It just gives the rim a little extra strength, so when you put the sock on there and the plants start growing, it'll be a little bit stronger. Cut it pretty much as short as you want to. There's nothing there that really affects the growth of the plant. In fact, it gives probably a little more room for the roots to grow out of the sock. The next thing you will have done is pop a couple holes into your cups with a hole punch opposite of each other. And the reason for this is once you put the sock down in there, you have to attach it to the cups. And I started using tie wraps after the rubber band started coming apart out in the greenhouse and letting the sock fall down into the nutrients. Now, the next step will be to add the tie wraps. You can use pretty much any length over 3 inches. Just locate the holes, put the tie wraps through them, put your skewer on each side, pull it up tight. Now, the next thing you'll do is go ahead and tie wrap about halfway down on the sock. Now, you can cut these ties off later to whatever length you want. And the reason why you would tie off halfway down the sock is that allows you quite a bit of length there to be able to add your perlite. That way you can pack down in there and have quite a bit of basis for the plant to put its roots through and give it some support. Now, some of these socks I have cut the tips off to where they're just barely touching the bottom of the container. Others I have left intact like this. I don't think it really makes much of a difference. Now, one thing, if you decide to keep the sock intact, make sure you cut a couple slits toward the tip right here. Otherwise, it'll fill up with air or carbon dioxide. I'm not sure what's filling them up, but they will turn into a big bubble and kind of float on the surface. And so just cut a couple slits and push it down, and it'll stay down into the fluid. I think either way is fine. That's really up to you. And your final step is adding your HydroSock to the container. Now, all you have to do is just take it and drop it down in there. And I've left my sock on this one full length. I don't think it makes hardly any difference. Now you just get it settled down in there. It's going to rest on the jug. Actually, these jugs will hold a lot of weight, as you've seen by my other videos. I start out using rubber bands to hold on the sock. That didn't work very well. Use the tie wraps. Now, once you've got that down in there, you can fill your sock with about 2/3 full with your perlite or perlite vermiculum mixture or whatever grow medium that you use. You can use the clay pellets or whatever you want to use. And you can also start your seeds in peat pellets outside of this and put them in later, or you can start them in the sock with or without the peat pellets. The first half of my plants were started without peat pellets, and they did pretty well. So that's really up to you. Let's talk about using insecticides. This is a brand that I use, EcoSmart. There are lots of other brands out there. I get this from Home Depot. I'm sure they carry it at Lowe's. I did not see it at Walmart. This happens to be an eco-friendly insecticide that's made from various plant oils. There's thyme, clove, cinnamon, about 10 different oils in here, and it claims that will kill virtually any insect that you'll come across in your growing, and it will also repel insects. I've tried it on some flying insects and they definitely did not like it. Now this says safe and non-toxic around children and pets. Well, you know what? My feeling is there's nothing that's absolutely safe or non-toxic. So I'd be very careful with it. I got some in my throat, my eyes the first night I used it, and it burned very badly. So I would be very careful with it. But anyway, this is just one of many brands. I've been using it for right on a month now, and I'm very happy with it. It seems to work as well as they claim. What I do is I'll spray it on the plants inside. Let me see if I can pull the door open and just show you what I would do. They say thoroughly wet the plants with it, so I'm just going to show you right now. And then I'll spray a little bit up in the air in case there's any crawling insects. And then I'll come outside and run a little bit around the edge of the greenhouse. I apologize for the long grass. It's been about 2 weeks since I've mowed, but you can see the idea. And I'll put a little bit around the door here, along the edge. And of course, I've got this open screen where the air comes through, and I'll just spray a little bit onto the screen. But anyway, I will go all the way around the edge of the greenhouse. I will cover the floor inside, and I'll spray it on the plants. So far, I've had great results. Not a single bug except for a couple little small earwigs. So I'm very pleased. Now I want to show you this tool. It's a lengthened funnel. It's made out of a long automotive funnel. Plus I've added about 2.5 feet of 3/4 inch PVC pipe with kind of a pointed end. And I just used electrical tape and then some white duct tape around it to hold it together. Keep it kind of stiff. Now, some of these plants are really hard to get to water, so all you have to do is just, instead of bending down and having a lot of trouble getting in there watering them, you stick it down into the plant like this, and you pour your fluids through the funnel down to the reservoir. Very useful. I can't get to the reservoirs anymore with a small funnel, and so this is just kind of an invention to help with that. Now, here's another tool I invented. You saw in the earlier videos, I used a turkey baster to rile up the water and the nutrient solution in the plants. That helps add oxygen, just mixes things up. Well, that got to be hard too. That got hard to kneel down and get down into the plants to do this. And so I took a 36-inch gray pipe nipple, which is usually used for irrigation. It's threaded on both ends. The reason why I picked that is because it's already threaded. And then I added to this end a 360-degree adjustable sprinkler head. It's called a bush or shrub sprinkler head. And all told, everything, the baster, the pipe, and the sprinkler head cost me about $6. Now, the sprinkler head can be adjusted to different patterns, but I've left it at full 360. And what happens when you squeeze the bulb, also I drilled a small hole right there, a thumb hole. That allows you to release some of the vacuum lock when you're trying to get air back into the bulb. And that way you can push air down in there, let it up, pull it back out, spray out some of the water through the sprinkler tip into the reservoir. And it just, with a little practice, it works really good. It takes a little bit of work to do it. Now, all you do is you just stick it down in to the reservoir like that. And of course, you would come up here and you would squeeze. Now, it's not doing anything right now because I don't have my thumb over the hole. But you would squeeze and pump air in there however many times you want to do it. And that also, like I said, it will aerate the top of the fluid with the spray. Very useful. I'm sure you can come up with different modifications to it. And I'll be thinking about it myself, but it's been helping a lot.